Hi, welcome back to the Luck Retreat channel. This is Sasha, owner and creator of the Little Luck Retreat and thelittleluckretreat.com. Welcome back. Excited to have you. So today our focus is socialization. One of the things that I am asked a ton by clients and friends and people once they realize that I have a dog business, how do I socialize my dog? And it's a super simple answer, but people tend to overanalyze and overthink it. And realistically, it kind of got me thinking, well, okay, so what is socialization? Socialization is not just playing. A lot of people think, I have to socialize my dog, I have to get them around other dogs, I have to get them to play with other dogs, and if my dog is not playing or engaging with other dogs, they're either not being socialized or they're missing out on that social interaction and that socialization. And where that can be kind of true, if your dog has no interaction with other dogs, you know, that's not necessarily healthy or good for them. But also, it doesn't mean that they're not being socialized. Some dogs, just like other, like people's personalities, some dog personalities really don't want to interact a ton. They might find one particular pup that they want to engage with, they really just get along with well, and other dogs just might not interest them as much. Also, you could have more of an introverted dog who just wants to observe for a long period of time before they can relax and actually go ahead and play with other dogs, or they might just be interested in doing other things. That's totally okay. So when I'm asked, you know, for daycare, you know, does my dog play? My answer is yes, most of the time, but they're also doing a lot of other things. So for me, I have what I consider the top five engagements that you want to make sure that you're getting your dog into for socialization. And those are basically what they're seeing, what they're smelling, what they can go ahead and touch with their paws and with their body, what they can move around either physically like a ball, or they can actually physically move within the space, and what they can engage with. So if you're taking your dog out to an experience like a park, or whether it's a dog park or whether it's just a regular walk kind of environment, or if you're bringing your dog to daycare, you're going to want to look for those top five things. Again, what they can see, what they can smell, what they can touch, what they can move within and physically move, and also what they can engage with. Those are the most important things. And the reason why is because they're skill building. They're not just, you know, playing with someone and building skills with that particular activity, but they're building skills on a variety of levels. And you really want to give the dog, your dog, a full spectrum of skill building. Like the top five I've just mentioned, not just playing with other dogs. Dogs definitely gain a lot from playing with another dog, but they also get a lot from just watching other dogs. Dogs can collect a lot of information from just the nuances, things that we wouldn't necessarily see, but the dogs are picking that up, whether a tail is up or down, the ear movement, body language, extrasensory skills, also, you know, obviously audible skills like growling or making noises, whimpering, or some dogs make kind of purring sounds. Any of that is super, super engaging for a dog while they're being technically quote unquote socialized. So when you want to socialize your dog, whether you're doing it yourself or whether you're bringing them to a daycare, you're going to look for a couple things if you're going to a daycare. And it's also okay to go to multiple daycares. I know people who will use us and use another daycare, another couple daycares, depending upon the direction in which they're going to work that day or what kind of activities they have planned. Just because different daycares offer different experiences, and that's just normal. But just like a person, your experiences, you want to have kind of a stimulating experience that's going to either stimulate you mentally or visually. Maybe one environment is better for your mood or the other. Your dog is the same way. So if it's a really rainy day, maybe an indoor daycare is great. If it's a beautiful sunny day, a daycare that has an outdoor experience would be fantastic. So you can also kind of play with that a little bit. If you're going to socialize your dog yourself and you're not looking at a daycare, that's totally fine. I would definitely encourage you to get out and maybe find a friend so you can get your dog together with another dog. But there's a lot of stuff that you can do on your own, either at home or in your neighborhood or in a dog park or dog setting environment that you can socialize your dog with. And down below, you'll see a link. There is a fun checklist that you can go ahead and print off totally free and kind of get that. Either you have a new puppy or a young dog, or if you have an older dog that just needs more socialization, the biggest thing is giving them experiences. And the checklist will kind of help you go through a bunch of the different things that you can do. But for the most part, again, you just want to build those skills. So what they can see, what they can smell, because their olfactory nerves are super, super advanced and so technical, and they can get a lot of information, a lot of stimulation, a lot of mental cognizant awareness by just smelling different things. And then what they can touch with their body, whether they're bumping it with their body or they can move it with their paws or their head, what they can literally move around physically in the space, like running or walking, or things that they can move around, like picking up sticks or moving balls. And then also who or what they engage with. Now, engagement can be a lot of different things. Engagement can be with another dog. Engagement can be with another human of varying ages. Engagement can be with ducks at a park, or we live near Seattle, so Green Lake has a lot of ducks, or you can go to a place that has a lot of geese, you know, things like that. That's engagement, and that is going to stimulate and socialize your dog a lot, as well as just interacting with other dogs. But it's going to give a lot of, that mental cognizant awareness and experiences. You can also have them, you know, be around, if you have friends with other dogs of varying ages, older dogs, younger dogs. A lot of local libraries have a Reading with Rover program. So if you have a very social dog that is well behaved, you can also enroll in, that's usually for free, a Reading with Rover program where they can actually, kids of different ages will read to your dog. That's another wonderful way to socialize your dog, especially around people and quiet environments. And then the biggest question is why? Why would I want to socialize my dog? Because especially after the puppy years, we all kind of get a little bit lazy, realistically, with socializing our dog, and that's totally okay. But especially as your dog transitions through different phases of life, from that puppy stage where they're just excited about everything into the kind of the middle age time frame where you might notice them sleeping in the corner more or going off on their own and just kind of slumping to the ground, looking kind of bored or kind of distracted by nothing in particular, but just kind of hanging out. That's a great time to kind of reestablish a socialization pattern with your dog. And so this will help eliminate anxiety. It'll eliminate stress. It'll actually eliminate restlessness, which can then lead to poor behavior if your dog is very restless. It will also help them sleep better at night, which is when you're sleeping, opposed to sleeping all day long and then maybe wandering or pacing or scratching or howling or barking at night. If you are gone for long periods of time during the day, this will also help make them more calm and relaxed while you're gone during the day. And then anything that helps build those experiences and build that confidence equals a happy dog, which equals a better behaved dog. So it is very important still to encourage doing that while your dog is going through those phases, even from midlife to more mature dogs into their geriatric years where they're a lot older. It's still good to engage them into a lot of socialization. And again, socialization doesn't just mean playing with other dogs, although it is great to do so. It can also mean sounds, you know, playing with different sounds so that they don't get startled, so they don't get anxious or fearful of different sounds, especially as they get older. Playing with different types of toys, rubber toys, moving toys, rope toys, chews of different kinds. You know, you can create quite a few, you know, fun interactive toys, even just a water bottle and putting different things inside, literally just a standard water bottle emptied out, put different things inside causing different sounds, and that can socialize and stimulate your dog, also reducing any kind of anxiety or fear with weird sounds like pennies inside, marbles inside, rocks inside, sand inside. Always monitor your dog so they don't crack it open and then, you know, rip open things and try to eat them. But those kind of things can definitely still socialize your dog to experiences, which again, build confidence, and that confidence makes them happier, and that happiness makes them better behaved. So just a couple things to think of. And then also a couple tips to how to start. So, you know, if you are interested in actually socializing your dog and you're thinking, I'm gonna do this myself, I'm not gonna just bring them to a daycare, which is totally fine. A couple different things you wanna do, start slow. The biggest thing is for your dog to gain interest on their own. So you don't want to force your dog to socialize. Now, if you're socializing them with just sounds or different experiences, you're going to introduce them. The second step is introduce and wait. And the third thing is positive reinforcement. So 1, 2, 3, start slow, introduce and wait, and then positive reinforcement. And what that will do, starting slow, allowing them to gain interest, introduce and wait. So once they actually start to acclimate a little bit to the environment, whether you are bringing them to a dog park and they're just kind of seeing other dogs play, or you're letting them go on a walk and just standing in one spot and they're just sniffing, a post or plants, that's okay. Just wait for your dog to engage, acclimate, and relax. That is the stimulization. That is a socialization for them. Now, a couple different things. If you're going to introduce them to dogs, you want to look for any kind of nuances, quiet body language that would indicate that they're ready or not ready. So if your dog has a really happy wagging tail, they're probably ready to go ahead, versus a tuck tail. That means they need more time to acclimate and feel confident and adjust to the environment. If your dog is very alert and ready to go, that's fine. If their ears are kind of like, ooh, interested, kind of moving around, checking things out, that is a sign that your dog is ready to go ahead and interact. If their ears are down or if they're kind of like curled, that's usually a sign that your dog needs more time to acclimate and, again, gain confidence before they start to go ahead and interact. And then the last thing would be a smooth coat. So if your dog has a nice smooth coat, their coat looks totally normal. If you have like a really furry or a really curly haired dog, you might want to just feel their spine. If they feel tense around the shoulders and around the tail, give them more time. If they have what's called a mohawk, it looks like their fur is literally up on end and it's a mohawk on the back spine, give them more time. And then if your dog does need more time to acclimate, use the third aspect, which is positive reinforcement, to really make sure that you are building that confidence. One of the biggest things I see people do is they pat their dog on their head like this, which is actually putting them into a submissive role. If you rub under their chin, you're actually asking them, lift your head, you're confident. And then you're relaxing them at the same time so they can be both relaxed and confident. And that, literally, just that switch from patting them on the head or patting them down to tell them, no, you've got to be submissive in this environment, to you're confident in this environment, everything's okay, will help your dog not only acclimate faster, but then start to engage and actually feel like this is something I can do, this is something I can enjoy. And then always watch for other people's dogs, because even though you might see your dog, you know, ready to go and ready to engage, make sure the dog that they are engaging with is also already acclimated and showing those signs that they're ready to interact. Because if they're not, that's where you're gonna get possibly a dog spat, negative dog interaction, where one's super happy and excited and the other one starts to kind of get aggressive or bare teeth. And then your dog starts to think, oh, now I can't. And they start to fear the environment as well. So look to the dogs that they're gonna play with and make sure that they are actually engaging with dogs that are also acclimated and ready to go. So just to recap, if you want to socialize your dog, that's fantastic. You can always do it yourself. I definitely encourage everyone to do it. In addition, even if they are doing daycare, to still socialize your dog yourself, because your dog needs to have those experiences with you in addition to, let's say, off-site, away from home, in a care environment. That's great, but it will actually make the care environment go more smoothly if you do have the interaction with your dog socializing on your own as well. And then whatever you're doing, make sure the location you pick, whether it is a daycare environment or boarding environment or an offsite kind of walker park, that you're looking for what they can see, what they can smell, what they can touch, what they can move around, and what they can engage with. Because those five elements will make sure that your dog is getting a full spectrum of socialization and an engagement, which will really, again, lead to a more confident, happy dog, which leads to a more relaxed dog, which leads to ultimately a better behaved dog. So if you have any questions, leave the comments below. I would love to hear from you. And otherwise, we'll see you again next time. Thanks. Take care. Bye-bye.